Now to the grouting. We'll mix the grout. Tiny bit of water in the bottom of the bucket, and you do not want to mix the whole bag all at once. You want to mix about a third. So, same as mixing tile adhesive, we're going to mix it until there's not much shine on it. It's going slightly dull, slightly sort of matte, if you like, and that it's hanging on the trowel. And we'll test our grout float. This is a grout float for grouting. And it's hanging on the trowel, as you can see, look. So we know it's not going to be all over the floor once we're picking it up out of the bucket and putting it in the joints. Now we're ready to start grouting. So pick a bit up on the grout float out of the bucket, and you want to be squeezing it into the joints one way and wiping off the other. Squashing it down in tight, wiping off the opposite direction. See how the trowel picked the next bit up? Well, I'm going to put it in over here. Take all the excess off with the rubber edges of your grout float. Continue on the same wall till you've completed the wall. Do not grout these corners because they're for silicone, so go tight up to them full depth, but not into that corner. So keep it out of there. Those little horizontals there, we'll need to grout those. Between the tile and the edge, we'll need to grout all the way down there, but not in the corner. Across all joints. Those metal edges, pick those up. I know that I've got that dribble on the face of my grout float, and so I've applied bits all down there. I'm going to run down again and pick them up so it's not all over the floor. I was getting too much on the float. Make sure you fill all the gaps between the edges and the tiles. Grout them to full depth. Watch out for pinholes like that. Go around and have a check. Grout does not stick to grout, so this has to go in all in one application and beautifully cleaned off. Keep checking the joints, any bulges like that, there'll be air pockets behind, so go over them again, around every edge, into those joints. A little tip, when your fan's dangling out of its position, put a plastic bag around it, saves you getting electrocuted. Take the towel rail off the wall. It's easier than trying to grout behind it. Now our sponging up. First sponge up, go over the centre of big tiles. Don't touch the joints. Try to give those one wipe over. We don't want to overwater the joints. It'll lead to pinholes in your grout if you overwater in the sponging off. So the first sponge up is like so. You want a proper tiling sponge. And every tiler I know, or I've ever known really, that's a professional tiler, uses a Zardex sponge because it's a proper sponge and it doesn't scoop the grout out of the joints, which household sponges do. So get yourself a proper tiling sponge. Top tip. We need a second sponging off because the first sponge up left this white film all over after it's dried for about 15 minutes. If we don't get it off the same day, you won't tomorrow. So, top tip, four faces to the sponge. We're going to use each face once, wipe, lift off. Turn the sponge, wipe, and lift off. You'll see the dramatic difference because you're not spreading muck around. So wipe across, lift off, turn the face of the sponge. Sponge on, across, off again. Then we've got the two edges of the sponge. Don't forget those. Nice even pressure across, lift off, and the final face. All tilers clean this film off this way, so it's a top tip, use it.
The amazing new Studhawk saw guide set. There are two Studhawks in the pack. The Studhawk 90 makes cutting square simple. And those difficult mitres, the Studhawk 45 makes them a piece of cake. The Studhawk helps keep your fingers safe and save time squaring a line. Get your Studhawk saw guide set today.